some of the things that are, you know, going through your brain when you're out there. So when I'm analyzing, when I'm watching the game and I want to tell you about a play, I just think about what I would be thinking as a quarterback and why that might gain an advantage for a team or might not, and what the defense is trying to do to maybe stop, you know, certain things from happening. And then you gotta do it quickly, and then you gotta do it in layman's terms. You know, so if I wanted to, you know, we talk about this stuff all the time, but if I'm gonna talk about an outside linebacker, it seems obvious, but when you say the outside linebacker rush this way, you better explain what an outside linebacker is real quick. You know, so while you're saying it, same as cover two. Not everyone knows what cover two means. You'll lose people real fast if you're like, wow, they played cover two really, you know, they did a great job rerouting. You know, all those things don't mean anything until you tell them what rerouting and cover two means.
You know how this business is, and it's hard to be universally loved, yet, I mean, you seem to get rave reviews from almost everybody. Were you aware of that in the moment, or did you consciously try to not listen to it and just concentrate on what you were doing, or how did you approach that?
I think playing football, you know, through your whole career, you kind of get a, I don't say you get numb, you start to learn that it, you just play the game, and some weeks it's good, some weeks it's bad, some weeks it's just part of the ebb and flow of playing, you know, in the National Football League and a quarterback. So you kind of get a turtle shell to outside noise, and in a good way and bad way. You know, if it's good stuff, same thing, bad stuff. So I think I was ready going into it, I guess, from the whatever the expectations or writing or talking would have been about it. But yeah, I think just feeling that people enjoyed it was rewarding. I mean, it is a little bit different. Football, it's a scoreboard. You know, they can, you can tell whether or not you play well at the end of the day. It's a little harder when it comes to TV aspect. And I just think you want to do as good a job as you can. Hopefully, you know, I want people just to enjoy the time they're with you and hopefully make the game a little bit more, you know, enjoyable. Hopefully they can learn. Hopefully they have fun. And then, you know, those big moments in sports when they come out, you want to make them bigger. You want to make them feel like it's larger than life sometimes. And I like when something's important. So I'm trying to make it that, I guess.
Your perspective as a quarterback, now that you got years of booth, has your perspective on the game changed in any ways?
I wouldn't say my perspective on the game has changed. I think, you know, I was a student of the game, so I love to understand and get beneath it and figure out why. You know, not just from my position, but why defensive coordinators think certain things, or why a coach is teaching this technique, and I think I've probably gained a little bit more insight into certain areas that I wouldn't have been privy to. So that's been enjoyable, just gaining more knowledge than I had. You know, when you're around the Bill Belichick a few times, you're going to gain some knowledge. So things of that nature have been pretty rewarding.
What do you still miss about playing?
You know, when you're done, you never know how it's going to go, but, you know, what I don't miss are probably the way I felt on Mondays after the games. You know, I've said that a few times. I think the competitive side of you always misses competing, but I feel like I kind of get that, you know, in some other areas, so it's been a little bit easier probably with my segue afterward, comparative maybe to others. Because you know, you get to into something else you want to be good at, so you practice it, so your mind just kind of goes there. So you know, I try and utilize that a little bit. So it hasn't been as hard as I thought it would be at first.
Have you given Jason any tips?
You know, just you know, Jason's going to do great. I think, you know, it's an exciting time when you go into that. And when you're changing, it's also the unknown, so it's scary, and it's, you know, you put yourself out there without a lot of reps. It's not like football where you can ease your way, or there's other people, and it's you, and you go in there, and then you get your partner right next to you, and it's just the two of you, and you're listening. So I think he's going to do great.
How much are you guys, are you going to critique him a little bit, or are you guys going to have any fun with kind of you and Jason? Maybe you're going to critique him, he's going to critique, like, are you going to see who is better each week, or?
I don't think we'll critique each other at all. I think you want to support each other, and you just want to do whatever you can to, you know, it's like any friend, just show them that you care, and, you know, we hang out, but it's not like, you know, we're not sitting around talking about philosophy of it every moment or something. And we're just buddies.
Can you talk a bit more about the preparation work of doing the game? I mean, beyond the interview with the players a couple days before the game, do you like, are you watching film at home?
Yeah.
You talk about the homework that you have to do that maybe people never take into account.
So I basically watch tapes similar to what I did as a quarterback. So I take the same approach. So I watch like coaches copy, and throughout the week, I'm trying to assess really what this team A is good at that week, or what they're good at this year, is what they're trying to accomplish offensively or defensively or on special teams. And then I want to understand what they're teaching and what their philosophy is as a coaching staff and what they're trying to teach their players. And you gotta watch until you figure that stuff out. And then you find out where their strengths and weaknesses are, and you try and now put it in your brain about what the opponent and the other team sees when they're watching that fits into their philosophy and how they're gonna try and attack it. So you're just trying to play the game to figure out what they're gonna do before the game starts. And so when you do that, you can have a little bit of an advantage as far as having an idea of how this game could go or what this coach is, on a certain side, what those coaches are gonna try and do to stop this other team's weapons from, doing as well as they have.
Could be a little nerve-wracking when you have anything on when you're on the air.
Not really. I mean, it feels like maybe the first time, but I think you just got to own it more than anything.
How's your golf game looking? And what do you want to do locally? When are you going to be entering this year?